Hi, my name is Jem Young, and I'm a senior software engineer at Netflix. And one of the things that I do is I move back and forth between the UI and the backend. If you're gonna be a well-rounded engineer, it's important to understand what exactly is happening on the server side. In this course, we're gonna learn how the internet works, command line basics, SSH. We're gonna learn all about nginx. We're gonna understand the how and why of Docker containers, server security, HTTP2, and even upcoming technologies like HTTP3. Enjoy the course, and I can't wait to teach you all about what it means to be a full stack engineer. Let's say I wanna type something. So right now I'm in command mode, so I can just hit I. And at the bottom of the screen here, we see insert. It means we're in insert mode. Hello. And to get out of insert mode, I hit escape. And now I'm no longer in insert mode. Right, we got this so far. It's intimidating until you start playing around with it. So to get into last line mode, I'm gonna hit shifts, colon. See, there's a colon here at the bottom of the screen. And to quit, I can say Q, but it's not gonna let me. Thus the Q bang if I wanna override. But I don't quit yet. Let's say I wanna save this file as something, I don't know. So I can say WQ. I didn't give it a file name. And I'm not gonna name this one, so I'm just gonna say Q quit. Did everybody manage to get in and get out? That's probably 90% of it, is just getting in, inserting something, and getting out. If I wanna create a file name, actually, I think we'll do it in the next exercise. Yeah. So just create a file. So I can say vi, call it temp. So now I'm in a new file, say, go into insert mode, say, hello, everyone, exclamation points. And to write and quit, say WQ. It means write and quit. If I just want to save, I'll hit write. Can't open file for writing. What? WQ. Try that. I don't know why it's not letting me write. Oh, I know why. This, we are going to learn a lesson in permissions. So right now I'm in root directory, so I'm going on a tangent. And you can't write things in the root directory. It just won't let you. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cd tilde. And what this means is it's just change directory, and this is just a shortcut for home. So now if I do pwd, I'm in my home directory. Now I can write files freely. Almost, actually not almost, no operating system is going to let you write in root, in the root directory. Just because it's a bad idea. You don't want to mess in here because this is the base of your computer, and if you start writing files left and right, bad idea. Next thing we want to do, now that we're successfully logged in our server, we know our server or our new user has root access, we're going to disable root. Because remember all those people trying to get in, it's never beneficial for them to get in as root. And root is one of the more common usernames, so they're going to try to break it as well. The first thing we need to do is we actually don't need to change the permissions. But for now, we're gonna change the permissions so that it's read and writable by our, or it's readable by our user. So you're gonna probably sudo chmod 644 and that authorized key file. So I'm gonna do that here, now that I'm in my server. So we'll see if I need sudo chmod 644 and sh authorized keys. Cool, didn't need sudo for that one. And we actually didn't need to do this step, but depending on what your server is set up as, you may need to do it. So I just added it in there for the future, just kind of bulletproofing ourselves. And all we're doing is changing that the permissions of that file so they're not read and writable by everybody. They're only readable and writable by sudo myself and certain file system daemons, like SSH daemon. The next thing we're going to do, now we're going to disable root login. So we're going to modify our SSH config, or the SSH daemon config on our server itself. So sudo vi etc ssh sshd config. And remember, you can always tab complete most of this. Say sudo vi slash etc slash sshd config. My password. And now we're in the ssh daemon config. The daemon is a program that's always running in the background. And that's what allows us to SSH in. We don't need to do anything to start it. We don't need to do anything to stop it. It's just constantly running and listening. And we're going to disable root login. So I'm just going to edit and switch that to a no. Is there anything else I want to change in here? Put key authentication, that's fine. Strict mode. I'll leave it as is for now. I don't want to mess too much with it. But with SSH daemon, you can do lots of things like enable password login, disable password login, have max retries, so someone can only retry a certain amount of times before it just bans them completely for a certain amount of time, maximum number of times you can be logged in as one user, things like that. We're going to leave that alone for now. A word of caution, anytime using sudo means you can do something really dangerous. We're modifying the SSH daemon configuration. You can modify it in such a way that you can lock yourself out of your own server, which would be pretty embarrassing. But if that happens, just start over again. You'll catch up pretty quickly. It's not the end of the world. These only become a real big deal if you have a production server. And you lock yourself out of a production server, no one can get in. The first thing I did was I backed up to the /var /www directory, and I ran git clone. So I cloned that entire repo to this var directory. And when you clone something, it's going to automatically create a folder for you. That folder was full stack frontend v2, so FSFEv2. And from there, I'm going to cd into that directory. So cd FSFEv2. We're on ls, we're looking good. Then I ran an npm install just to make sure I have all the packages in there. Should be up to date. Cool. But now I have two node applications running on the same server, or on the same port. So I want to kill the other application because I don't need it for now. So I'm going to kill that. So I'm going to say sudo pm2. And the first process was at process 0. We only had one running, so we're going to stop 0. But because I already have it running in process 0, I'm going to stop it again. We're good to go. Cool. So now 0 stopped. I'm going to run sudo pm2 start. We're going to run this other application. But I've already ran it. I don't want to start another process. But you would run sudo pm2 start app.js. So now we've stopped the other application. The other one's running. You're good to go. Unfortunately, we still need to tunnel the WebSocket connection through nginx. So we use what we, this, oops, there we go. We have to set those proxy upgrade headers in nginx. So in our nginx configuration, in our location block, right above the proxy pass or below it, doesn't really matter, we set a proxy header. We want to set an upgrade header. And then we want to set another header for connection upgrade. Pretty good so far. I'll give you a second just in case. It's a lot of typing. Your hands are probably hurting by now. You've used the command line maybe more than you've ever used it in your life. That's good.